So I have a question for you. Are you finding that fasting is interfering with your ability to sleep through the night? Now, I've actually spent quite a bit of time to try to find research on this point. And all I could find is just a very tiny bit of research in animal studies, okay? Mice studies. However, I do know quite a few people who have told me that their sleep is not as good when they're doing fasting. This could be the reason right here. So in the study, energy restriction was applied for 2 to 7 days, 2 to 7 days of fasting. And what they found is it decreases nocturnal, that means at night, secretion of melatonin. This is the hormone that helps you sleep, by 20%. So if you're finding that when you're putting your pet mouse on a fasting program and they're not sleeping, you want to do two things. And I'm being very sarcastic. You can actually apply this to yourself as well. You want to add MCT oil to your diet right before bed. Or you can try this. Increase your carbohydrates to 50 grams. And that should help. Maybe add more berries, something like that. And you'll find that you'll do a little bit better. And the reason for that is that chances are you have insulin resistance, and it's probably been there for a long time. And it's going to take a while for you to adapt. You see, what you have to realize is that glucose is one fuel of the brain, and so is ketones. The majority of population has insulin resistance, and it's affecting their cognitive function. And we don't know exactly, but it's almost as if the blood-brain barrier gets insulin resistance, okay? And what happens is the cells of the brain don't get the glucose. And so when you have an Alzheimer's patient, what's really happening with the neurons is it's starving of glucose. And that's what happens when you have insulin resistance. And guess what is in the brain? You have the mechanism that controls sleep. It's in the front part of the hypothalamus. It's called the suprachiasmatic nucleus. Not that you need to know that, but anything in the brain is going to be affected when you have insulin resistance. So what you're going to find after you do keto and intermittent fasting over a period of time, the pineal cells will start adapting more and more, and your sleep will do better. But in the process, you may need to add some MCT oil, which will give the brain ketones and feed the pineal gland directly. Or you can actually just increase your carbs a little bit more and see which one works for you. Now, if you haven't seen my video on all the different ways to stimulate melatonin, that might be a good video to watch next. I put it right here on the screen and a link down below.